All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to my ride to work on what is quite possibly my coldest ever ride to work. It, according to one of the weather channels, it is currently below minus 30 out. And we need to get to work. So I pre-chilled my Garmin for a few minutes in the front porch. Take as long for it to cool down to the ambient temperature. We're on our way. We'll have to see what the temperature ends up reading. Yeah, I checked with Environment Canada. I woke up, which is the government forecasting and Thunder Bay Airport. They said it was minus 31 Celsius. It's going to be a long ride to work. Feels really, bike feels super slow and sluggish. These temperatures, nothing happens normally. The battery on this camera might not even last all the way to work at these temperatures. I've got 5 layers on top, upper body, that thin polypropylene that has a windproof front, like my base layer. It's like a cross-country ski top. Like, it's designed to be worn under a cross-country race suit. Thin, but it has a stretch windproof panel, and then I've got a heavier weight top over that, like a mid-weight top, and then I have I guess you'd still call it mid-weight, but it's a jacket. It's like a slim fitting insulating jacket, and over that I have a loose fitting, medium weight underwear top, which actually fits over everything. And then I have a shell jacket. And then for my legs, I have cycling shorts, a thin pair of Halti long underwear. Halti is a Finnish brand. Again, it has a windproof panel in the front, hole in the crotch, in front of your legs, down and just below the knees, and over top of that, medium weight long underwear, and over top of that, my pants, which are windproof front, breathable back. They're lined, like the windproof front has a lining on the inside. It's not really insulated, but it does have some insulated qualities. And then I've got snowmobile gloves on. And on my head I have balaclava. It's a thermal balaclava. It's pretty thin, but it has like brushed fleece on the inside. But it's a windproof panel on the front, and then a small mesh area in front so that you can breathe through it. And I have a lightweight Lycra Crusker de Ski Toque. And then over that I have a, I think it's called Oregon Designs. It's like a fleece hat that I only pull out when it's cold. It's kind of goofy looking. But a friend of mine gave it to me. Okay, so we're 6 minutes into the ride. And the temperature is minus 27. So one interesting thing I noticed previous times that I've ridden around this temperature is how the ice, in a sense, becomes less slippery. It gets so cold that the moisture in it is all trapped. Because the reason you slide is because you're sliding on a film of moisture. When it gets this cold, there's less of that moisture, so sometimes the ice actually starts to get tacky. Now it's minus 28.2 Celsius. We're less than 8 minutes into the ride. Interesting to see if anyone at work has issues starting their car this morning. Now minus 29.7. Now minus 30.2. Minus 30.4. Okay, it hit minus 31 on my Garmin. So that's the coldest I've ever ridden in. But it seems like the temperature is going to keep dropping. Oh, so over the Christmas break there, I started watching a TV show on Netflix. It's called Peaky Blinders. And I have to say, it's probably the best TV show I've ever seen. It stars Cillian Murphy. It's about post-World War I gangsters in the UK. So all these criminals, gangsters, went and fought for their country in World War I. And then when they come back to the country, they're war heroes, but they go back to being gangsters and criminals. It's awesome. There's 4 seasons on Canadian Netflix. It's called The Peaky Blinders. Best TV show I've seen. I'd say it's better than Breaking Bad. Okay, we're feeling reasonably comfortable. It's now minus 31.7. But now hit minus 32, which is the coldest I've ever ridden my bike in. All right. Already had to switch the battery. These temperatures, that battery lasted 15 minutes. Isn't very good. 15 minutes. So I had to take off the gloves at minus 32 Celsius.
So, hey guys,
not much of a riding vlog that turned out into. So what ended up happening is when I switched out the battery, 2 minutes later, the camera shut off again. And I'm like, well, it was a freshly charged battery that I was keeping close to my body. So there's no way that the battery ended up dying that quickly. So the only thing I could think that happened is the GoPro itself got too cold. Because at that point it was at minus 30 Celsius for around 20 minutes. And it didn't like that temperature. It just shut off. So, which is interesting because, you know, I've used my GoPros down to minus 20, minus 25 Celsius, and they work fine, except for the shorter battery life, they work fine. But it looks like once you hit the minus 30s, GoPro, my Hero Plus, Hero 3 Plus Black does not like minus 30 Celsius. It will just shut down on you, which is kind of disappointing. This is what ended up happening. So we ended up seeing minus 32.6 Celsius on my Garmin. So that's a personal record for me in terms of the coldest temperature I've ever ridden in, and ended up being an average temperature of minus 30 Celsius for the ride. We can go look at the graph here. So the max temperature, we started at minus 12 because basically my Garmin was inside the house and I put it in the porch for a few minutes before I left to cool it off a little bit. But it starts off not reading the true outside temperature because the unit has to cool off. But you can see it drops, temperature continuously drops, and then we hit minus 32 about a quarter of the way. Well, maybe more than a quarter of the way, and it stays at minus 32 all the way to the end of the ride. Once I got to work. So yeah, that is my personal record, minus 32 Celsius on my fat bike. So yeah, my coldest ever ride. It's a personal record for me. Thanks for watching. Bye.